Howdy everyone, this is Duval from KE and welcome to How to Improve Your Cyber Hygiene. In today's episode, we're going to talk passwords. But before we can talk passwords, we need to define what exactly is cyber hygiene. So let's get started. Can anyone tell me what is cyber hygiene? So, what is cyber hygiene? Think of it this way. Cyber hygiene is really no different than regular hygiene. A set of standards and practices that we use on a day-to-day basis to maintain our cleanliness from infection and disease. And cyber hygiene takes a set of standards and practices that we use on a day-to-day basis to protect ourselves while we're dealing with the Internet of Things and when we're online. According to Digital Guardian, cyber hygiene is a reference to the practices and steps that users of computers and other devices take to maintain system health and improve online security. These practices are often part of a routine to ensure the safety of identity and other details that could be stolen or corrupt. Much like physical hygiene, cyber hygiene is regularly conducted to ward off natural deterioration and common threats.
One of my passwords for something is
password.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
My phone password is 8008.
3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3.
It's all threes.
Mine too.
0802. It's my grandpa's birthday.
It's my dad's name, who passed away.
What's your password?
My password?
To what?
Bank account?
I just do different versions of my Chinese nickname and then birth year.
Birthday.
What's your password?
It's something.
Password.
I'm not telling nobody that.
Why not?
My password is the same for everything.
So if I told you one password, you'd be able to unlock my life.
Has to do something with Zelda.
It always includes my dog's name.
What's your dog's name?
Java.
Why are you telling me this?
Cause he's so special.
What's your password?
Should I say that?
Probably not.
Honeybun 88.
Soup 28.
I like honey buns.
Hoops 24/7.
What accounts do you use that with?
Most of them.
Think you protect yourself enough?
No. On my desk at work, I have a post-it note that says my password to everything.
Why don't you try harder?
Because then I'm just going to forget a password.
Have you ever had your identity stolen?
Probably.
Probably will as a result of this video.
I've had someone steal, like, my credit card information.
That's 4 of your social.
2753.
3072.
6719.
Why are you telling me that?
I don't know.
What's your password?
My oldest son's name and his birth month.
My son's name and his age or his grade.
What's your son's name?
Ben.
Capital H, hotshot, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Should I even be saying these? Wait,
people are making them up, right?
I wish more people made them up. What's your password?
Bubbles, period, 16.
What's that to?
That's to everything.
You just told me your password to everything.
I mean, you don't know my username.
Ooh.
Ooh.
What is this?
So let's talk passwords. Passwords need to be strong and complicated. We're at the site, How Big Is Your Haystack? What this site does is it allows you to experiment with passwords to see how strong your password really is for cracking software. As you can see, I've already typed in a password. It meets the criteria of uppercase, lowercase, digits, and symbols. My password is capital AGG, exclamation point 3, dollar sign, capital U, lowercase n, number 1, lowercase v. As you can clearly see, it says Aggies University. When we create password, a lot of times we create passwords that we can remember, but we do try to make them complicated as much as possible. So I've met the criteria, and if you look down, it says, according to all the password cracking software, that How Big Is Your Haystack is running against this password, that in 1 week, this password would be cracked. So what really makes a strong password? A lot of us believe by adding more special characters and symbols that we're good, or as long as it's not a dictionary word. What really makes a strong password is actually, believe it or not, the length. And as you can see, by me just typing in the rest of the characters, it will take 13.44 billion centuries to crack this password. So as you can see, it's the length of the password that makes it stronger. And that's why it's important to use a password manager. Password Manager will help you to manage all of your passwords. Now, I know that the majority of people will use the same password for multiple accounts, and that's what you don't want to do. Also, remember to use two-factor authentication as much as possible. Your password is the only line of defense between you and an attacker. Okay, guys, that's it for today. Thank you for tuning in to today's episode, and be on the lookout for the next episode. If you guys have any questions at all, you can always email me. Have a good one.
You just told me your password to everything.
I mean, you don't know my username.
A couple million people are going to see this video.
I'm going to go home and change my password.